Hi, in this video, we'll create a development build that can run on Android with EAS build. So let's get started. So back to our project. And for Android, the development build must be an APK, especially if you want to test on an emulator or on your real device. So while the default Android format is .aab, which is ideal for Google Play Store distribution, it cannot be installed on devices or emulators. So to create an APK, we have to make sure that we are using the development client flag equal to true in the development profile. Finally, we can trigger the build using the EAS CLI. So let's clear the terminal and I'll go to the doc that we are referencing, in this case, Android development build, and I'll copy this command. Let's go back to the project and paste it in here. So what we are doing here is just running the build command using the EAS CLI, and we are specifying the platform. So we can do this by saying platform, or you can simply pass the flag P like this. So in this case, let's use platform. And then we are specifying that we want to run this for Android only, and we need to tell EAS which profile we want to use. So let's go ahead and trigger this build. This is going to kick off a new build on the cloud using EAS. But first of all, it's asking me which package do I want to use for my application. So because this is the first time that I'm running this command and I haven't specified any configuration for my Android project in here, it's telling me, okay, do you want to use this package? So I'll just go ahead and hit enter. I'll use the default, which is com beto at expo split is, and then generate a new Android key store. So I don't have a key store, so let's go ahead and generate one and let EAS handle this for us. So I'll just say yes, it's creating a new key store, and then it's going to upload the project to EAS to start the build. So while the build is in progress, what I want to do now is go to the document. So once the build is done, we can install it in our Android device in many different ways. But one of the ways is using Expo Orbit. So if you haven't used Expo Orbit yet, basically it's a tool that allows you to install and manage your simulators super easily. And actually I have it installed in here. As you can see, it's this little planet, and we can see all the devices that I have in here. It's really nice that it's detecting my iPhone 15 Pro Max just by using Wi-Fi, and also it's detecting my Android devices. So I'm using a Pixel 8a. This is my real Android device that I have in here with me, and just so that you believe me, here it is. And this is really nice because now I also see which one is running. And I can also select a build from EAS and then select the device that I want to run this build on. So go ahead and install Expo Orbit if you haven't already. We're going to be using it for the next step. Okay, I'm here in the dashboard, and as you can see, the build is done. It took roughly 10 minutes, but once the build is done, actually we can install it from here. As you can see, we can install it just by pressing this install button, or we can use Orbit, or we can just go to the code and install it on an emulator. So from here, I can just press Y and it's going to install it. I'll just go ahead and press Y, and this is going to install it on my emulator. So let's select that one. So here's my Android emulator. And as you can see, I have this successfully started your app, but in this case, I didn't start the server. So if you remember, when we are using a development build, we need to have the server running. So I'll say npx expo start, hit enter. Okay, now that I have started the server, I can come to the right and fetch again the servers. And you can see that now the server is running. So let's select this one. This is going to start bundling the application into my Android emulator. I'll press continue. And everything else should work the exact same way. But in this case, we're using a development build that we created in the cloud. Which is great about this is that now we can come to the index and start modifying stuff. Like for example, just quickly add a test, and you can see that anytime that I save, this is going to reflect the changes on the emulator. So now let's install this on a real Android device. So for this, I'm gonna be using Android Studio to mirror my real device, which is a Pixel 8, as you can see there. And I'm using their tool, which is running devices. This little icon, you can use it to mirror your device. So I'm just gonna kind of put this on screen like that. And from here, actually, what I want to do is go to my Android build in here. And then I can open this with Orbit. And then you can see that it's downloading the build. You can also see that it's detecting my Pixel 8 down here, and it's running it right now, as you can see over there. So now let's go ahead and select the server. And this is going to start bundling on my real device from my local server. So if I show this in camera, you can see that it's my real device. And if I press, you can see that this is going to load the application and everything else just works fine. What is great is that I'm able to test this using a development build, which can run native code and also allows me to make quick changes and see them reflected in my application. So if I save, you can see that now it's there on screen. So creating a development build, it's only required to do so when we are changing the native code of the application. In this case, this is only JavaScript, so we can continue developing with the benefit of live reloading. But just to end this lesson, I want to mention as well that we can just click install in here and scan this QR code with your device. So I'll just go to my device and open the camera, scan this QR code, and this is going to open my Expo dashboard. And from here, I can select again, install, and this is going to download it, as you can see there. Once the build is downloaded on my device, I can run it directly from here. So, I mean, install it, so I can just click it. This is going to ask me if I want to update this app because I already have it. So I'll just say update, and then we can open it. And this is going to work the exact same way, right? So now if I come here and make some changes like test and save, and if I go back just so that you can see that this is working on my device and I'm getting real-time updates. That's it for this chapter, guys. A quick recap. We learned how to build our application for Android using EAS build. We also learned multiple ways to install the application, like using Orbit, just scanning the QR code, or just selecting yes on the CLI once the build is done to install it on an emulator. I hope you liked this chapter. I hope you learned something new. Don't forget to subscribe, give it a like, and I'll see you in the next one.